On behalf of Chulelal Institute of Technology, I heartily welcome all the participants for this much awaited faculty development program on e-vehicle. This FDP will cover the following saline points like introduction to electric vehicle, that is EV. Why does society need this type of vehicle? Then current status of EVs and HEVs, that is hybrid electric vehicles, the general structure and functionality of EVs, new developments and future technology of EVs. This FDP will also cover vehicle dynamics and modeling, propulsion system, battery management system, the general structure and functionality of EVs, auxiliary systems and sensors, business opportunities, new developments and future technology of EVs. The need for electric and hybrid electric vehicle is because of two main important points. One is environmental concerns. Current use of heat combustion engine is a major source of air pollution and may be a cause of global warming. And second is practical concerns. Because in our traditional engines, we are using oil, petrol as a fuel, and it is not quite certain how long the stock is available. So because of these two points, a lot of advancements are taking place in the area of e-vehicle. Requirement is the mother of all innovations. Due to larger number of advantages offered, larger use of e-vehicle is quite obvious. Positive change in customer perceptions, technological advancements, and greater interventions from government like subsidy are combining focus on e-vehicle. Electrical cars have continued their steady development over the years. With the advancement in battery life and efficiency, their travel distances are now becoming viable for a broad range of business and personal uses. Just recently, Chevrolet, similarly the Audi India, announced the release of their series of e-vehicles in India by 2019. To meet the demand of industry, number of courses on e-vehicle is introduced by number of Indian and foreign universities. The course on e-vehicle is also available on online platforms like NPTEL and edX. As we know that there are three types of e-vehicles currently used, and they are classified on the use of electricity in that vehicle. The first one is battery electrical vehicle. Second one is plug-in hybrid electrical vehicle, that is PHEVs. And the third one is hybrid electrical vehicle, that is HEVs. The uptake of EVs is the result of several factors, including strong technological progress, cost reduction, especially in batteries, and policy support from the government, including purchase incentives, driving and parking access advantages, and increased public charging infrastructure abilities. The five major challenges facing the electrical vehicles are: number one, change takes time. As per the government policy, diesel and petrol cars will not be allowed after few years, but still it will take some time. So high use of e-vehicles certainly takes some more years to come. Second is limited choice. The number of modules, vehicles that are available are quite few. So customers are not getting the enough choice in the selection. Third challenge is backing the right technology. As the number of technologies are evolving, so industry are yet not sure to use which type of technology is the best. The fourth challenge, who will pay? For e-vehicle, there will be a lot of infrastructural requirement like charging units, charging stations. The question will arise, who will pay for this type of amenities? The last one, fifth point, is the zero carbon fantasy. Even though e-vehicle will substantially reduce the carbon emission, but it will not lead to the 0% because of the material that is used in the battery and other will definitely also contribute for the carbon emission. So it is not the zero emission. It is very necessary to understand customer concerns regarding e-vehicle. The first parameter that will come in the customer concern will be the driving range. With full charging, how long you can drive that vehicle? So in my chart that will be shown, it is one of the concerns. In some country it is 31%, in some country it is 35%. Second parameter for the concern is the cost, that is price premium. The third concern that is coming is the lack of electrical vehicle charging infrastructure. Even now, the enough charging infrastructures are not available. Right now, better facilities are available in US and European countries, but over in India, it is not to the recognizable level. The next point is important is time required to charge. How much time the charging unit will take to fully charge the battery. Lot of research is going on this area to reduce this charging time. The next point from customer point is safety concerns with battery technologies. How safe is the use of battery, its charging, its life, and any type of accidents that may occur. The next point is all battery electric powertrain is not offered in number of versions like SUVs, truck like this. So these e-vehicles are right now available in limited number of models only. And the last concern is the brand preference from the customer. From particularly for the few customers, they are always attached with some brand, and if the e-vehicles are not available from that brand, then they may have that concern. The current areas in which the teaching fraternities or researchers can contribute are, one is to reduce the mass. Second will be decrease material and manufacturing cost. Third one is improving the hardware. Fourth point that can be a point for the research is battery or the alternate material that can be used in the battery. Following, e-vehicles are right now available in India from different countries like Maruti Suzuki, Hyundai, Tata Motors, MG Motors, Mahindra and Mahindra, Nissan, Renault, JLR, Audi and Volvo. So lot of Indian and international companies are showing their interest in the development of the e-vehicles in India. It is important to understand demand and supply ratio in context of the e-vehicle. Right now, if you will see this chart, there is always a demand for e-vehicles in 2020, and it is quite clear from this graph that this demand will totally increase up to the year 2030. I am confident that this demanding faculty development program on e-vehicle will meet to your expectation. I am thankful to convener of this program, Professor Rohan Ingle, HOD Electrical Engineering, Mr. Rohit Ramteke, and Ms. Surbhi Srivastav for coordinating this program, and is their entire team for organizing this FDP. Best wishes. Thank you very much.